Hi, welcome to Chapter 3, Part 1 of Class 6th History NCERT textbook. In this chapter, we are going to study about the oldest cities discovered in the Indian subcontinent, and Harappa was the first one to be discovered amongst them, that is around 80 years ago. And that is why all the other sites discovered later where we found similar kind of buildings and other things as that of Harappa, we denote those sites as Harappan. As I have repeatedly told in my previous videos as well, that the earliest cities in the Indian subcontinent developed around 4700 years ago from now. That is near 2700 BC. Now talking about houses, drains and streets. All three of them were probably built at the same time, because they had to be compatible with each other so as to have a good city plan. Houses were either single or double story high with a courtyard in the center and rooms built around it. Wells were used for water supply and most of the houses had a separate bathing area. Drains were fully covered, laid out in straight lines with a gentle slope so that water can flow down easily. Drains from houses connected to those on the streets and inspection holes were provided at intervals to clean them. All this points out the beautiful city planning they had done even in those times. Now let us talk a little bit about the structure of these earliest cities. Most of these cities were divided into two or more parts. That means one part was for the rich and the other part was for the common or poor people to live. The part where rich people lived was usually made on a higher elevation in the west and is called as citadel, whereas the other part where common man lived was at a lower elevation in the east and is called as lower town. Each of these parts were often surrounded by a wall of bricks, and the speciality about these bricks was that they were so rich in quality and were used in an interlocking pattern which made the wall so strong that it has lasted for thousands of years. Now have a look at this map of earliest cities in the Indian subcontinent. I hope you can point out Harappa. Some of them are located in Punjab and Sindh province of Pakistan, whereas the others are located in Gujarat, Rajasthan, Haryana and Punjab in India. Now as I told you, the citadel was only for the rich, then you can expect some special buildings built here as well. One example given here is about a special bathing tank in Mohenjo-Daro, which is called as the Great Bath by the archaeologist. Maybe this tank was used to take a dip on special occasions. Not just Mohenjo-Daro, every city marked on this map had a unique set of objects dedicated to it. Like Kalibangan and Lothal had fire altars called as Havan Kund in Hindi, where sacrifices were performed. Similarly, Mohenjo-Daro, Harappa and Lothal were famous for their storehouses. Now let us talk about the life in the city in those times. City life was quite busy. There were rulers, craftspersons, herders, scribes, travelers, etc. doing their own job. For example, rulers were busy planning the construction of special buildings in citadel or sending people to distant lands to get metals and precious stones for them. Whereas common man like craft persons made different kinds of things like beautiful clay pots, terracotta toys, etc. etc. Some people traveled in search of raw materials as well. Not everyone knew how to write in those times. Those who did were scribes. They prepared seals, textual documents, etc. Now we will talk about the crafts in the Harappan cities. Most of the things were made of stone, shell and metals like copper, bronze, gold and silver. Metals were used to make weapons, ornaments, tools and vessels. Some of the special finds are those of beads, weights and blades. You can see a red colored necklace made up of beads in this picture. These beads are made up of beautiful red color stone called carnelian. In the second picture, you can see carefully shaped weights. These were made up of a stone called chert. These were probably used to weigh precious stone or metal. In the third picture, you can see a stone blade, probably used to chop something with precision. We found rectangular shaped seals made up of stone with an animal carved on them. Beautiful pots with black designs were also found in these cities. Cotton was probably grown in Mehrgarh around 5000 BC, and we have found pieces of clothes and spindle wools made up of terracotta and faience as well, which tells us that they used to weave clothes too in those times. Have a look at this stone statue found in Mohenjo-daro. Look how beautiful his beard and embroidered cloth is carved. This work must be of a specialist. A specialist is a person who is trained to do only one kind of work. This statue must be of some important man in those times. What is faience? Unlike stone or shell, faience is an artificially produced material with a shiny glassy surface, usually blue or sea green in color. They were used to make beads, bangles, earrings and tiny vessels. So as to keep the video short, I will stop here and see you in the next part of this chapter. Till then, take care, bye bye, Jai Hind.